The first lecture is presented by Professor Maeda Shingo, who is a professor from the Department of Engineering Science and Mechanics. Professor Maeda, please proceed.
Yes. It's an honor to be here and to present my work. So my name is Shingo Maeda. I'm working with Engineering Science and Mechanics in SIT. Okay. So, I would like to talk about soft and wet robotics. Okay, so they are the industrial robot in factories, which is very hard. And, you know, this is very useful for us. And they show high speed, high precision, and high reliability because they have to always conduct same things repeatedly. So this is the important things for industrial robots. Okay, so look at the left side pictures. You can see the woman is holding a child. So she's my wife, and the child should be my son. And, you know, this is very easy for us, like holding babies. But, you know, the conventional hard robot, it's really difficult to do something like holding actions and also like holding eggs because the eggs, you know, very fragile. And on the other hand, now we are organizing the project of soft robotics in Japan. And the very famous professor in Tokyo Tech, who is Professor Suzumori, he's very famous in the world. And trying to make science of soft robots. So you look at the left side pictures, and these are the concept of soft robots. Okay, so the value of a soft robot is totally different from conventional robots. Okay, and another point is that the very young researchers are joining this project. Okay, look at the right side pictures. You can see many young researchers, including me. I have to say that the soft robots include the flexibility, adaptability, and softness. This is the point. Okay, so I will explain about the examples of the soft robot in the world. Look at the left side pictures and about the stretchable pumps. So our group in SIT and EPFL group developed the stretchable pump. And we use the electrochemistry and mechatronics, which is the fusion among different fields are now very, progressing. And another example of the soft robot in the world is the integrations between materials and digital fabrications. So the rapid prototyping can accelerate the fusions, of course. So now this kind of interdisciplinary area is expanding very, very rapidly. Okay, so please look at the left side graphs. So y-axis shows the number of academic papers against the years. So after 2010, so you can see the, rapid increasing of academic papers in soft robotics. And another point is that many, many researchers, like not only engineers, but also the material science and the physicists, mathematicians. So many researchers are joining this field. And then as a result, the field is expanding rapidly. So I was lucky because I obtained the sabbatical leave from SIT and I joined the a very big laboratory in Italy of the soft robotics. And she is the boss of the Italian university, who is Cecilia Raschi. And she organized the first international conference of soft robotics. So this is the first conference for soft robotics. And now still this conference is expanding in the world. Okay, so today I will talk about three topics. One is soft mechatronics using stretchable electrode. The second one is soft pumps. And third one is soft active materials. So I'm doing many research projects in soft mechatronics and collaborating with many professors in the world. Okay, so this is one of the my project, so dielectric elastomer actuators. So look at the left side pictures, and this is the simplest very simple structure is very simple because the two stretchable electrodes and one dielectric elastomer, and you know the structure is very simple and just capacitance, and you apply the high voltage to these materials, and what happened? So look at the video. So the black part, this is a stretchable electrode. So you can see the expansions and, you know, a recovering process repeatedly. So this is kind of the actuators. And, you know, the energy density is very high. And very, you know, silent operations. And there are many researchers are interested in these materials. So looks very simple. So, but the mechanism is very complex because we have to think about the three, you know, things. One is pure instability. This is mechanical instability. Second one is electromechanical instability. And the third one is electrical breakdown. So we have to think about these points. So looks simple, but the mechanism is very complex. Because the rubber, you know, elastomer shows the highly nonlinear elasticity. So for this reason, the system becomes very complex, but useful. So many researchers are making nice DEA. Normally, in DEA fabrications, we need a lot of, you know, equipment, something like this. So we need of course, money to buy these equipment and also materials. Of course, this is one method to make DEA very precisely. So very recently, my PhD course student, one student is, his nickname is Adi, he's from Indonesia, and he's working with me about the DIY fabrication method for stretchable sensors and actuators using just brushing. Okay, so please look at the left side pictures so we can make DEA very, you know, easily, and the system is very reliable. So look at the video. So this is the not actuators, this is sensors. And you can see the motion tracking. And every, you know, product are made by us and very, you know, rapidly. So we can make the system integrations using brushing. And another topic is the In. She is from Thailand. And currently, unfortunately, she's not in Japan. She's now in Thailand because problem of the COVID-19. So, but we have to do something. And she decided to make a software like machine learning to make a motion capture system. So about hardware we are making in SIT. So through internet, we can make some integrations between hardware and software. So this is one of our project. And previously, we got the Sakura Science project from JSD, and we invited the UTM group, so who is Professor Ahmad Atif, and we are collaborating together. And this is the overview of the project. So another second project is Soft Pump. And as I told you, the soft actuators are very useful. Okay, for instance, this is the pneumatic actuators created by Sumori Sensei. And look at this. Okay, so let's skip. So look at this. So there is no control, but the soft hand can, you know, manipulate the screw very easily. So which means that fluidic actuators are very useful. But the problem is that pump is very bulky, heavy, and noisy. So this is a problem. If we apply this system to the human-machine interface or our environment. So we focused on the electrohydrodynamics. This is kind of the electrochemical reactions. Anyway, so look at the video. This one. So this is the dielectric liquid, and we apply the high voltage, and then we can see the fluidic flow through the electrochemical reactions. So we thought that we can apply this phenomenon to the electrically driven pump. And then we are now trying to make a rapid prototyping method using EHD and the digital fabrications. So making process is very easy, and we can make nice EHD pump just using the commercial product. And then we can make a 1 gram pump, soft pump. Okay, you can see the circulations of the, you know, this part, okay? And the third topic is soft active materials. This is, okay, anyway. So they are my project. And basically, I focused on the gels. And what is the gels? So this is stimulus-responsible gels. And I don't know if you know this or not. And some gels shows the volume changes in response to environmental changes. For instance, thermoresponsible gels, they show the swelling when the temperature is low. And when the temperature is high, this gel shows shrinking, something like this, which means that we can control the volume of the gels by controlling the environmental situations. And another, okay, so I will explain about another things. So look at this chemical reactions. This reaction is very beautiful because you can see the concentric oscillations, something like this, okay? And also this is another aspect of this reaction. It is called busy reactions. So you can see the chemical waves, something like this. You can see the concentric waves. And as previously, the hydrogels coupled with these busy reactions shows very, very small volume oscillations in 1996. So I was so excited when I saw these gels. And then I focused on these hydrogels and applied to the soft actuators. So look at the gels. So there is no external controls. This hydrogel can work by driven by just chemical reaction or busy reactions. Okay. And so still I'm doing this project. For instance, we develop the peristaltic motions of the gels. And okay, so very recently, we developed the completely autonomous soft pumps of BZ gels. Okay, so I have to explain about the things. Just a moment. So the environmental situations of this reaction is very acidic. Okay, so gel is immersed in the strong acidic conditions. So there is some limitations for applications. And then we made self-actuating pumps. Please look at the right side pictures. And here, this is the gels. And we prepared the thin membranes. And then we obtained the self-pumping just using these hydrogels. So without a battery. Okay, so we just use the chemical reactions like heartbeat. And recently, we collaborated with the Riken Group in Japan, and we made very small pump microchannels with pump of these hydrogels. And finally, we obtained, just a moment. Okay, so look at the right side video. You can see the fluidic flow in microchannels. Just a moment. Okay. Which means that we completely developed the artificial heart. So there is no battery, indeed. Okay. So in these presentations, we introduced three types of soft robot. One is soft mechatronics using stretchable electrodes. Second one is soft pumps. And third one is soft active materials. And future direction is, of course, soft materials bridge people and machines. Thank you for your attention.